evening, and welcome to tonight's edition of The Mizrahi Memo. I'm Rav Rick.
And I'm Rabbi Fagan. And here are tonight's top stories.
Has Dr. Bailey gone too far with the bathroom passes?
New apparel in for the boys' basketball team, and you'll never guess where the zipper is this time.
Huh. Has Rabbi Linfield gotten a new dog?
The newest population affected by power school is the least likely you would have expected, and they never saw it coming.
And what's going on with parking at school?
And also, where is Rabbi Teller?
Those stories...
and more.
On tonight's edition of...
The Mizrahi Memo.
In a shocking new development, we've received word that at Mincha this past Thursday, in a first for this year, there have actually been no boys wearing tefillin. Sources are still trying to figure out why that was. Some experts are saying it might be related to the fact that the boys' basketball team is in New York. We will keep you posted as this story develops.
In an effort to boost their confidence, the boys' basketball team went out and got yet another piece of useless athletic apparel. But, as the great Vince Lombardi said, what you lack in skill, you make up for in style. I went out to do some investigative journalism, and here's what I found.
Investigative journalism.
You say. Hi, I'm Rabbi Matt Fagan on the scene here with Junior Avi Small. I see you got some new gear in. Can you tell us a little bit about it?
Yeah, I designed these sick... awesome, cool hoodies for the basketball team.
Yeah, after asking some of the fellow students, we just had a few questions.
Yeah, sure.
I see that they're sweatshirts. Where are the sleeves?
It's actually a sleeveless hoodie.
A sleeveless hoodie. So it's a sweatshirt that you would wear, but not to keep you warm.
Correct.
I understand. I also see that it's t-shirt material.
It's quite thin, actually. Yeah, it's more for style. Nowadays, looking cool is more important than being warm.
I understand. I see you got Nike to sponsor your sweatshirts. How did you secure that sponsorship? I understand.
I'm not sure.
Yeah. Can you speak a little bit about the zippers?
Stop with the question. I just ordered them. I don't know. Stop with the question. I just ordered them. I don't know.
A lot of students have been asking about Color War lately. Unfortunately for them, it happened last week. Too bad, only 15 students were in school to enjoy it.
A lot of ed clicks have been going out lately, and a lot of students have been wondering, who is this website, and what does he want from my parents? The newest population affected by power school has been the teachers. They've gotten a little dose of what power school anxiety really means. Let's take a little bit of a closer look with ourselves.
Time. I remember my first time
exactly.
Shadowing Rabbi Pollack as well.
I can't wait to see
him. He is such a good mentor, not just in class, but in life.
Yeah.
Anyway. Oh my god.
What?
Rabbi Joel just posted my weekly teacher evaluation.
How'd you do?
On Teacher Power School.
How'd you do?
I'm checking. My GPA just dropped 0.02 points.
It'll be okay. Listen, these grades are not...
This is my GPA!
I know, but... it's just one bad score. You can't do this every week.
My GPA!
Rubric.
My teacher.
It's just one bad score, man.
I have a question about...
You're such a drama queen sometimes. Look, it's not a big deal. I'll check mine. It's not a big deal. Okay, see? He said that I...
I got a 9! Oh, I got a 9 out of 10! Yes!
Yeah.
Rabbi Joel,
yes.
Could I ask you a question?
Yeah, Rav Rick, hi.
It's not important now.
Okay.
I noticed that you gave me a 10 out of 30 on this assignment in Power School, and I'm wondering why it was. It was the professional development write-up assignment.
So, Rav Rick, first of all, I didn't give you anything. That's what you earned. And the reason that you got that was you did a third of what I asked, so I figured you earned a third of the credit.
Are you kidding me?
Listen, I think it fits
Are you kidding me? Of course, yeah, I did a third of it because the other two-thirds were annoying and I didn't want to do it.
Right, but that's not really your choice to say, so you only...
It is my choice.
Well, you only earned a third of the credit. That's how it works. If you did 100% of the credit, you would have gotten all of it.
Oh, what, this is ridiculous. Oh my god, are you kidding me?
Listen, Rick, one day you'll thank me for this.
I won't.
Yeah, so, okay, so I'm wondering why my GPA dropped, like, 0.4 points. Because you put in a grade from that professional development day and you gave me a zero.
Were you there?
Okay, so I don't know why that's relevant, because so I was first of all I was
were there, did you come on time?
Okay, first of all I was there, and second of all I was not on time.
I think you came 2 minutes late, is that possible?
Okay, anyway, that's not the point, because you never said you were gonna take up points for being late. But you asked me to run that group and I know I didn't run it. And you asked me to submit a write-up about it, and I know that I didn't. But I'm just wondering why you're getting a zero on it, and like my whole GPA is out, and now I'm never going to get into college, and now I'm never going to get anywhere in life, and I'm going to work at Amy Joy, maybe if I, you know, get that job, and it's your fault.
So you're saying that because you got a zero on last week's professional development day, you're going to work at Amy Joy?
Yes, and I'm saying that it's your fault because it's not my responsibility to earn grades.
Private channels, can I speak to you for a minute?
Oh, sure, have a seat. What's up?
I saw that you posted the grades from our last Tanakh meeting on PowerSchool.
I did.
And I just...
I'm sorry it took so long.
I wanted to talk to you about it. I know that I haven't submitted any of the Tanakh meeting requirements over the last 12 weeks, but you don't understand what this grade's going to do to me. You know, my dad always checks in with how my scores are, and... Is there any way I can make it up? Like, maybe I could write an article for Mizrak Shemesh, or I'm leaning at Teen Minion. That's part of Tanakh. I was just wondering if maybe I can make it up somehow and then pick my grades up.
You know, maybe we could think about a makeup, but, you know, if you want some extra time to do the assignments, I might be willing to.
No, I really don't want to make up any of the assignments. I just want to do something different that would count for those missed assignments, please.
But the grade is for Tanakh meetings. It's not for leading a youth minion.
You know, but it's Tanakh, and... Sorry.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Sometimes the grades are really weighing me down. Are you sure I can't lean?
I don't think so. But if you need to talk to someone, Dr. Bailey's probably available.
Dr. Bailey, he gave me a bad grade in PowerSchool too. Okay. Thanks.
Can I say Milana?
Dr. Gosman, great job this week. I gave you a 10 out of 10 on the teacher evaluation. Did you check your power school?
What? He doesn't even work here! Come on!
Wow. Some raw images there.
Yeah, that was...
It's a little tough to watch at certain points.
Yeah, it was hard. It was hard.
Anyway, in lighter news, a lot of you have been wondering why I'm sitting in Rabbi Teller's seat. Well, let's take a look at what he's been up to lately.
Since leaving the newsroom.
Hey there. Do you like tefillah? Do you like Rabbi Blau? Do you like old people? Well, you're in luck. Every other Tuesday, tefillah with Rabbi Blau and old people. Menorah Park. Granny always said, beauty is in the eyes of the beholder. Hi, I'm Rabbi David Teller. You may remember me from previous commercials about Rabbi Blau, Menorah Park, and old people. Do you like art? Do you like robo? Do you like art with robo? Well, guess what? You're in luck. You can spend your mornings in an undisclosed location with robo doing art. Just remember, with robo, it's never arts and crafts. It's always artistic expression.
Well, thanks for watching. We'll be back after a short break and a word from our sponsors. Stay tuned. Tired of teachers always telling you what to do? Taking away your phone and PSP during class? Telling you to do work, hand in assignments, come on time, be prepared to class, be conscious during class?
Guys, please quiet down. Please take out your homework.
Open your Gemara. Yeah, you need a pen. You need a pen. Or a pencil. Do you have your notebook? Guys, please stop talking to each other. Okay. You can't lay on the floor. You gotta sit in a chair. Yeah, at a table, not... Thank you.
Well, we have the solution for you. The Mizrahi Magic Card. With our new product, you'll never have to worry about any of that ever again. Here's how it works. Say your teacher asks you to do some ridiculous instructions like, please put your phone away, or take a seat and take out your worksheet. Huh, unbelievable, right? Well, the last thing you want is to hear your teacher nag you over and over again to keep doing the same thing. I mean, you heard him the first time, right? Well, now all you have to do is take out the Mizrahi Magic Card, follow the instructions, and you're done. Just like this. I mean, am I right? Here's what some real students and administrators have to say about the Magic Card.
Magic Card. I haven't heard of that. A couple weeks ago. I guess between Israel and conferences in New York and other conferences and back to New York and Xbox and sick kids, I don't know, it's hard to keep track of the new trends in school.
So at the beginning of the school year, I mean, it was tough. I didn't know if I would still be on the basketball team because my grades were plummeting. I was doing very bad in school. When Edan told me about this magic card, I was like, it's not for me, like, probably what everybody says, you know? But then I tried it, and I could not believe the results. I mean, it actually worked. And now, I have a great relationship with all the teachers. I'm doing amazing in school. My mom finally loves me again.
Ah, the magic card. I remember when it was first proposed to me. I was at a conference in Nova Scotia. The idea seemed so complicated but simple. Unique, but every day. I don't know where we would be without the magic card.
Well, I bet you're wondering at this point, what is the magic of the magic card? Well, we're gonna let you in on our little secret. It's really three simple words. Follow the rules. Now let me break that down for you. Step one. Follow. Now, that's really the second simplest of all the steps. What it means is, when a teacher gives you instructions, you do the instructions. The second step is, well, it's the word the. It's not really a step as much as it's a preposition. And that's really the simplest part of the whole thing. Finally, we have rules. And what that means is, well, there are rules, and you follow them.
Look, I know it seems crazy, and I didn't believe it either, but you have to try it. I can't explain it. Just try it. It works. It actually works.
Thanks, Magic Card.
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 School ain't hard when you've got the card.
Follow the rules. It's really that simple. And teachers will never nag you again. Because the first time they ask you to do something, you'll have already done it. And then they won't have to ask you ever again. Try it out. We'll see how it goes.
Can you say that? Thanks, Magic Card.
What's this for?
Perm feel.
Thanks, Magic Card.
One more time.
Thanks, Magic Card.
One more time.
Thanks, Magic Card.
Well, that was something else.
Really, really thought-provoking. Provoking thoughts.
Yeah, I didn't think they'd make it. Well, let's hear from our students for just a moment. We'll be right back after this.
Wonder what they have to say.
Me too.
Before I start, I'd like to give a major shout out to Ruffy for participating excellent in class today. It was amazing.
As many of you know, I went to a Basyakov school growing up.
I was talking to my mentors about my upcoming debut of giving Sikha to you guys.
I was in line in the grocery store. Is this awkward?
All right.
Yeah, this is awkward.
Don't we know this week's Parsha? Not at once.
Now, as many of you know, I'm a huge Jays fan.
I realized that my transition from Pittsburgh to Mizrahi is very smooth. I even convinced Jack and Nati that I went to school with Mac Miller and Wiz Khalifa.
No. Jacob Steiger.
Shmuel Aleph.
Close, a little bit sharper.
Shmuel Bet.
A little bit more.
Titsava.
There we go, good job, Jonas.
Thank you.
2015, it was Game 5, the ALDS, and Jose Bautista hit a major 3-1 shot.
As many of you know, I was a Saracek MVP, a EULA legend back in my day, but it's not something that I like to brag about.
Excuse me? Are you gonna come in? Are you?
Yeah, so take what I said now and put it in abeyance for now. We'll go back to it.
Shout out to my seatmate, Rav Rick.
As you all know, my sikhas have one specific style. I learned it from my mentor, thank you, Rabbi Pollock. And it goes like this.
So I was talking to my mentor's mentor.
So I was at Machina Stone, and I was visiting with my wife Lou and Molly. And we see Yehuda Rothner. Everyone here knows Yehuda Rothner.
I went up to my friend, and I put my arm around him like this. And I noticed he was really skinny. I'm Yehuda Rothner! Bnei Yeshiva!
Excuse me.
Like, bro, did you lose like 15 pounds in 12 minutes? Like, you're really skinny.
As we were.
I'm Yehuda Rothner!
I've told this story a couple times, but I think it's relevant here too. So when I was in high school,
and then some lady responded, "This is Mrs. Feigenbaum." And I was, "Oh no." And I ran away.
We were supposed to run around the whole park, but you see the coaches, they didn't come with us, so they wouldn't know if we took a shortcut.
To remind you that we don't have phones during Sikha.
I'm sorry about that.
But me, I knew the value of doing what I was told to do. I knew that it would benefit myself. So I ran around the entire park. Shortcuts are bad. Do good.
And with that, I'd like to wish you all a good Shabbos.
Gardner. I'm the average black man you'll see probably walk down the street anywhere, any place, anytime. I like chicken, mostly fried, and dipped.
Barbecue.
And some type of barbecue and or a warm sauce.
Alright, my name is Coach Dudes. I like barbecue chicken. I like all type of foods, really. I don't eat pork.
No
beef. Pork.
We don't dine on the swine.
What's wrong?
I don't know. It smells like I opened a can of cat food.
It's like a biscuit.
It smells like I opened a can of cat food.
I cooked biscuit, man.
What is? What's this? Is this raspberry?
It's a horseradish with beets.
That's horseradish?
Yes.
I've never had horseradish before. What is horseradish?
It's like,
all right. So is it like it's a whole thing? You got to get all three scoops?
It's just cold.
I don't know.
Man,
guys all hear you.
Oh, all right. You know what? I don't want to be disrespectful. I'm saying, all right.
What is this?
That is a wet piece of toast.
Can you heat this up? Or
yeah,
no?
Can we have
why
it?
Is it cold? Hold
this on, is dude. Like a plate of revenge.
It might be better.
This actually tastes this is like because I made a run to these suicides.
Man, it's like cat food.
This, I'm going to give this to my cat.
This is
I'm
cat
not
food.
Eating
this.
For the guy, man. This is cat food. I can't do that. I'm cool, man. I'm not going to eat this, though. Yeah. Thank you, guys.
Okay, so this is good. Built a fish?
Is it cold? Oh, it's ice cold. Is it supposed to be cold?
Yeah.
I am not a fan of that smell.
It smells like wrapped tuna fish.
Yum.
Normal carrot.
Ew.
Okay, it smells like wrapped tuna fish.
Should I start it with the horseradish?
No, go on its own.
I ate some of it. I didn't eat any more of it, but I ate some of it.
The consistency is like...
I'm not going to take that big a bite. I'm going smaller.
The consistency is really gross.
Sorry.
It has like no aftertaste, so that makes it easy to eat.
Same thing with straw.
I guess so. It's not so bad. It's not so bad. If it has other stuff with it. Did you try it with the horseradish? I'll try it with the horseradish.
You guys look forward to this?
I feel pretty good.
That is horrible. No, thank you.
It tastes like potato. It smells like potato.
It's like a potato salad.
You got any ketchup?
I don't know why I would get that big of a piece because I dove into the filter. All right, here we go.
Man, why is all this cold? Why can't we get that and it's warm, man?
Why you keep saying stuff? I'm trying to eat. First of all, it's on my hands now.
Everything is not.
It just tastes like a, I don't know, man. It's just so, why do I have to eat it cold? Because you gotta have a microwave on the Sabbath? I wouldn't, let's just say I wouldn't have my wife.
It's better than the last one.
It is way better than gefilte fish, though.
Yeah.
It's better than gefilte fish, though.
You have any ingredients with this? Like a side of ketchup or like salt?
Yeah,
or something?
Can we have some hot sauce with this?
You want some radish? You got more radish?
I don't want no more of that radish. No, man, don't bring the radish back. Yeah, and this might help this.
Yeah,
I'm not eating this no more, though. Thank you.
Potato kugel. I don't know, Jack's involved.
This sounds like German. I'm excited about this.
Could be a bit warmer.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of the temperature, but this is delicious. Is this like is this a Tisch thing? Is this a Shabbos thing?
Both.
Ooh.
This isn't bad. Mm. It's like creamy hash browns, kinda.
Don't say creamy. That makes it seem worse.
Congealed.
Now I'm not going to
congealed
hash browns. I'm thinking. Filter fish is a zero. This is a solid five.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to chelling if that's on the menu.
If.
Man, it's like a smell.
Bean
pot burger. Roast.
Black bean burger.
The beans in here.
What do I think this is? It looks like something. This looks like a pile of something that I would be upset in the middle of the night that I was walking through the dining room and my dog threw up under the table.
It's that bad, like chili.
All right, here we go.
It's like chili.
I'ma just scoop shit. I'ma just scoop. Here we go.
It's like chili.
You remember I could, all right, okay. All
right. Yeah, this ain't it. This is really.
I'm not much of a bean guy.
Right.
And my wife is gonna be offended later, probably. But, because I have like instant reactions to beans.
Man, why do y'all bring shawarma? Jesus Christ.
This is what you're gonna eat.
Shawarma is a 10, though. Where's shawarma?
Where's schnitzel? I like schnitzel.
This is actually a different type of schnitzel.
Bienen? Is it Bienen? I'm not eating that shit. No.
This is schnitzel.
That ain't never been schnitzel. And I'm not eating
man,
that.
Man, this is.
I know schnitzel when I see it, and that ain't schnitzel. We go. No.
Man, get out of here with this.
Who eats gefilte fish? Do that to yourself.
Spam.
I understand it's religion, but don't do it to yourself anymore.
This is really spam.
It's religious food, right? Don't do it to yourself. It's okay. The God will be okay if you don't eat gefilte fish. Right, so, which fish are in there?
Yeah.
A cod, I think.
Shark?
Shark?
Did somebody already eat it? Just chill it.
Fuzzy chili.
Oh, the worst part of it, it
really
smells good.
Good,
it just looks
Yeah, it is not an appetizer.
Like, it looks like a dog just went
it.
To the bathroom.
Mm-hmm.
But it smells good.
That's colorful.
Yeah.
Well, this is the best of the three.
Oh, this is really good.
Mm. It's just like really, really, really thick chili.
It's missing cheese.
Mm-hmm.
And sour cream.
Oh, could you imagine? A little bit of cheddar cheese and some sour cream.
So they could never combine that.
I like this one a lot.
Yeah, we could eat that stuff. It's fatty cordon, you know what I'm saying?
Ooh,
that might be better.
Pork chili?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What do you guys think's in there?
Beans? Meat?
There's certainly
beans.
Some beans in here, lad.
Some
yeah,
sort
but
of
there's
tomato
some really,
paste?
There's some really big, like, what's this? Is that a potato?
Maybe. Or an onion or something.
It's just like super, super thick.
Is it usually this? Is it like a thick stew like this?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You remember when we went down to Clyde on the sailing ship? They had that lentil, a little bit of that.
I remember.
I know. It does have a slight haggis taste.
You didn't have any of that lentil soup they made on the boat?
I'm not a lentil. No, I didn't. Remember, I was sick because the ship was moving.
Well, you were steering it.
Interesting stories.
That was part of it. Mm. Okay.
Yeah, it's not bad.
And this is a hard 10.
Nah.
This is delicious. I eat this all the time.
Jewish food, this is like a 9.
Jewish food is a 10.
Regular food, this is like a 6.
That's fair. It's pretty good.
Because there's stuff you could add to it that they couldn't add to it that would make it better.
Cheese and sour cream.
Cheese and sour cream.
Okay.
More seasoning, not as thick.
Yeah.
But it's a hard 6. A hard 6. It's above average.
Hmm.
Gefilte fish was probably like a negative 30.
You could make a smoothie out of this.
Oh, absolutely.
Now you ruined that. You ate all of that?
That was really
what's this
good.
Called?
Cholent.
Say it again. Cholent. Cholent.
Is that with a yud? That was good. What's in that?
Potato, beans, meat,
barley. Oh, I got a big
barley.
Piece of potato right there.
Meat?
Yeah, there was beef.
I had ice cream. I'm placered for 3 hours.
I'm
out. Thanks, guys.
$60 billion. That's the record profit earned by the insurance industry.
Look, he was going to go easy on you so as not to hurt your feelings. But he's only going to get this one chance. Something's coming. I can feel it. Just a feeling I got. Like something's about to happen. But I don't know what. If that means what I think it means, we're in trouble. Big trouble. And if he is as bananas as you say, I'm not taking any chances.
Right next in a short order.
Beginning to feel like a rapper. Red shot from the front to the backside. Now who thinks their shot is enough to ask why? They say I lay like an empty, so call me rapper.
The lane like a Balcora must be my jeans. I got a tycoon, I'm a real Jew. And I read from the Torah each new moon. And you'll see soon how I read smooth. You think I'm Ashkenazi party tunes. And I know Hop Torah for every Shabbos. And I even dance a horror like a novice. Chosid. I'm a no myth, still is modest. But it's true and it's honest. It's Shmuel. Think the bold Rabbi Pollock, still a Marlin. It's Elay Makite, my Ebias Ema. You don't really want to get a stag match with this rabbi rap tracing away in his place. In the bass, dot, a page, bass, yes, chasing a mace. The exact same time I attempt liturgical hatchback stunts while I'm practicing that. I'll be complaining that there goes the entire laning over the heads of a couple of head yo pretending to get. All those comments uncalled for, but you lane so badly, I had to react. How could I not though, you're a piece of the T-Bore, see you're lacking pizzazz. Rabbis are having a rough time period, but you're actually sad. In fact, it's quite a tragedy, man. What you lack while I'm masterfully constructing this masterpiece as?
I'm beginning to feel like a rabbi. I have red shots from the front to the backside. Now who thinks your kasha is good enough to ask why? Look, I know you know not every Jew is that high.
New Jews are taking a school with the coolness, and they use it as a vehicle. Serve Hashem, now I give a sicha to the students. Me, I'm a product of Rashi, the Ritos, Fora of Gottlieb, Ramban, Rav Akiva, and Ari's also think that they got me. Inspiring enough to one day grow up, blow up, and be in a position to have the big three induct me into the very special Rebbe. A Rav Hall of Fame, even though I walk in the shul, all cool, semi tallest lame. Only Hall of Fame I'll be inducting is a new parish Hall of Fame, but it's all the same. It's a more than just a game, till they call me up by name. To the Bima, no, Lee, I just got Galila. So you keep rushing, I'll be patient. I'll get my ordination. Shabbat is your vacation, for me it is an occupation. Refraining from creation. Shabbat.org, cause you're yet to have explored insightful statements. You just lack my dedication. I look for God in nature, I'm the next biggest commentator. You both say words, you period. Only common denominator. It's me.
My questions are brutal. Your learning's been futile since my refutal of what you've proven. And I just bought a shofar for a Rosh Hashanah, not to blow with Kavana, like when Rabbi made Elay mad. His Rav said he looked like a fool with a green road shul, seen chakra with a men's Kavana. Man, oh man, little did he know that it was heir of Rosh Hashanah. So Elay went straight to pray for exoneration the very next day. Hey God, please forgive me. Sleep was coming at you at supersonic speed. Oh, Shamanumba got a new gazala new hey vino. Lots of new mirage new niatanu and teitanu. Looked over when I studied you so that everything I'm saying ricocheting off the ground into Shemaya. And my body swaying more than ever when I'm praying. I could give another shot to an audience to diving with 5-star rating. Concentrating since I know my type of intoxicating. And the way that they all fairly knew it's exhilarating cause I know the way to keep them captivated. You make meditating spila, I make motivating spila. Oh, he's too slow though. Well, guess what do during a meeting with my music. 18, bruffo, sing one. Cause I found a hella way to fuse it. Slicha, and bakasha. Just add hold down, watch the juice sing. I don't know how I sing songs like that. I don't know what tunes to use. Pay attention while I prune to you that the souls of everyone. These humans blooming too. Afternoon, I'm not assuming, but Minchla, you. And how many baboons have I got to listen to? Prove that if you sing twice as nice, your songs couldn't sacrifice Minchla to. Bow Korah, read Torah, and I follow all of the Misora. Love to learn, but still a Mora. I'm hard on myself, cause I make me do what Alucha says to. When I'm 15 medrins above you, keen when I find a chance to do. Me, folks, good deeds, thank you. I'm done, so Moshe, go and take my seat. I'm a stand of the Shtender, donning my keeper and Tzilin. Still in my soul, there's something I can feel, tugging and struggling. Angels praise Hashem, and here's what they want from me. They're asking me to try to go and say Shema twice every day, but if you take consideration the busy schedules that we have, you may be a little patient and more sympathetic to the situation and understand the new Jewish nation. But listen, life's handing you something, save for Shabbat then. But if I can't turn on the oven, how the heck am I supposed to make sure it's hot then? Don't mistake it for easy. It's a mental mistake if you think you need to be so my feet and do every mitzvah to be a Jew. It isn't just a religion. Don't be a Russia, be a king. Think not. Why be a king when you can be a Rav?
I remember the Fenwick parking lot. And don't get me wrong, it had a ton of character, but a lot of potholes. A lot of character, but fortunately, equal amount of potholes. And then we made the move. I was in sixth grade, and I remember the first day, I was on bus 22. It was a decently long bus ride. I was unsure of what was gonna happen. And we rode up on the apron. And I remember when the wheels first touched the asphalt, and it was so smooth, very, very smooth. You know that scene from Cars where Lightning McQueen, he does the whole thing where he repaves the road in Radiator Springs, and it's really smooth, and all the cars like drive around in it like crazy. So that was kind of what it was like, at least in my recollection of the events. But then, you know, flash forward. Four and a half years later, and I'm in 10th grade. And I finally get to bring my car to the parking lot. I've been looking forward to it for a while. And my Subaru, great car. It's already a pretty comfortable car. But the second it touched the asphalt of the Fuchs parking lot was the second my driving experience was changed forever.
Every year, to celebrate Yom HaTzmaut, an interscholastic parade is held around Beechwood. The magnificent Mizrahi parking lot consistently sets the tone as the place of origin and inspires the participants to celebrate amazingly. At the conclusion of the parade, all of the participants gather on the side of Mizrahi for the side lot spotlight moment of the year. In a wonderful display of competition, the three schools put on individual Daglanu performances. These flag dances require a strong base for the kids to stand on, and the parking lot does a wonderful job at that. Its well-paved surface allows for optimum flag bearing and complex dance movements.
They see me rolling, they hating, patrolling, they trying to catch me riding dirty, trying to catch me riding dirty, trying to catch me riding dirty.
Oh, Hanan Haas, how was it? How was your bike ride today?
Well, you know, just the usual, a few hills.
How was the parking lot when you came in?
Well, I mean, it was smooth. The asphalt is just flat. No, nothing bumpy.
The parking lot was good, huh? Nice to know. Was the other park good? Oh, getting a drink. Oh, spritzing on. Oh, look at that. It's Hanan Haas, everybody. The legend.
Yeah, I mean, top spots of the bike rack, as always.
Oh, nice. Where are you?
Like, right on the left, closest to the school.
Oh, nice, nice. And why is that good?
I mean, like, you know, like, it takes, like, you know, an extra 2 seconds to, you know, walk in from the further spot.
From the furthest spot?
Yeah.
Okay, okay. Cool, cool.
The 2 seconds really matter to me.
Oh, the 2 seconds?
You know, those can make the difference.
In yet another display of events, the Mizrahi parking lot continues to hold true its title as one of the best in northeastern Ohio. Its fantastic accompaniment and hosting of the monthly fire drills is noteworthy. As students flock the lot, it is still not phased. Teachers pace back and forth, ensuring that all kids are accounted for and are safe. That is just another day in the Mizrahi parking lot. Until next time.
You see, I was charged with doing an advanced statistical analysis of our parking lot. And I found that if you take the factor of number of near misses between cars and pedestrians, add that to the amount of time on average that it takes to exit our parking lot, divide it by the amount of water that gathers in the walkways when it rains here, added to, of course, the number of inches of snow left after Wayne says that he plowed the entire parking lot, we come up with a very important factor. We call that the PPF, the parking lot productivity factor. It's a very important number, and it has taken a precipitous drop. You see, it used to be at a high of 97.23696. Now, it's down. In layman's terms, the parking lot's terrible. And we have found that it's because of three main factors. You see, number one, Friday afternoons, issue number one. Number two, there is a disregard for student rights, as evidenced by the new laws enacted in the parking lot. And the final factor seems to be connected to the lack of respect for the ever important fuel-efficient section of our parking lot.
So, let me set the stage. It's 2:30 p.m. on a Friday afternoon. It might be a little warm, might be a little cold, and it's absolute utter chaos in the parking lot. You've got middle schoolers, high schoolers, lower schoolers, ECP parents, random visitors who just decided to come at 2:28 p.m. What is that? And then you even have Mandel parents encroaching upon Mizrahi real estate, our coveted parking lot. It leads to complete disaster and anarchy in the parking lot. And it's not an image that I like to see every Friday. And it could end up disastrous. And it needs to be improved upon.
Good afternoon. Thank you so much for taking your seats so quickly. It's something new, a new initiative I want to share with you. It's really to benefit the ECP, but for the little kids to be dropped off and for them to be picked up by the parents, the parking spots are being taken. So we're going to have a new system in place. Everyone's going to get a tag if you have a car. Early childhood parents can park in the early childhood parking lot. If you're a teacher and you have kids who are going to the early childhood program, you can also park in that lot. In the main lot, however, teachers are the only ones who can park in that front area. Okay, what we'll do for you though to make sure that you have a place to park is you have the spots on the side by the athletic entrance. You can go there, we'll make sure that door is open for you, and you can park there. So you'll get a student tag, you'll go to Kathleen, register your car, teachers will have a different tag, and that way there'll be room for everybody. Thank you so much for your understanding.
So please, tell me how you feel about the parking lot at the moment.
The quality is depleting, and it sucks. Like, I don't even drive here, but the walk to get, like, you know, I know the reel comes in, like, 8:09, and I gotta walk extra instead of, like, I gotta run instead of walk. It sucks. It really, it's bad. It's really bad.
Some brave students have begun to fight for their rights in resistance to the unjust rule of the administration. They will not back down.
Not the kids. I don't care about the students. This is not for them. This is for us.
I will always fight for my rights. I will always stand my ground. They can try and abuse me and take my rights away, but I have the right to park in the front of the parking lot. They cannot take that right away from me, and even if they do, even if they arrest me, I'll take it. And I will be peaceful, and I will show them that I have the right. I am a student, and I have rights in this school just like everybody else.
In the Mizrahi justice system, parking-based offenses are considered especially heinous. In Beechwood, Ohio, the dedicated detective who investigates these vicious felonies is a member of an elite squad known as the Parking Lot Unit. This is his story.
Excuse me?
Sorry, didn't see there.
What are you doing?
I'm doing a little bit of research on, fuel-efficient parking sections and our repeat offenders.
What exactly is it that they're doing?
Well, basically, there's this section that lets us qualified for this LEED certification. And this LEED certification is very helpful and looks very good on our school. So there's this parking section called the fuel-efficient section. It's made for fuel-efficient cars. And basically, you have to have a score of 40 on the official California Board of Review for each car. So they rate each car. And you have to have a score of 40. And these cars, these Honda Odysseys that you see, repeat offender, repeat offender, repeat offender, all or do not have scores of at least 40. They have scores of like 16, which is completely irresponsible. So I'm just doing a little bit of research, making sure people like these stay off the street.
And what do you have written down there?
I have the list of our repeat offenders. So obviously, in this corner, we have DRG 8196, Honda Odyssey. In this corner we have FUM 2189, and obviously right here we have MCH 5396, and I really hope that, these people can be put to shame, and because it's really unacceptable. However, there is this one car that not even could get a photograph of, and it's so rare. I don't even think I've ever seen one in the wild. However, there have been so many reports of this one car. It's a beige Toyota Sienna. From 2001. And this car has a score of 9. It's the lowest score of all of history. And its license plate is FHJ 4598. And my mission, my goal in life is to finally catch this one repeat offender. And I hope that he will surrender. I hope that he will stay off the streets. And I hope that he will park in the section that he deserves.
Thank you.
I'm OG, y'all new to the game.
That's all the time we have from the Mizrahi Memo. Thanks for joining us.
Until next time, remember, we're more than a community. We're a community.
Happy Purim.
Okay, that's a wrap. That was good.
I think you actually have something in your feet.
Here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Get in the,
I zoomed up on. You say that? Thanks, Magic Card.
What's this for?
Perm spiel.
Thanks, Magic Card.
One more time.
Thanks, Magic Card.
One more time.
Thanks, Magic Card.